Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn a new chapter of 12 accounts. The name of the chapter, as you can see, Admission of Partner. From your earlier knowledge, you know that in a partnership firm, a new partner can be admitted with the mutual consent of all existing partners. So before we start to the numerical concepts, let's see some basic concept about admission. Let's take an example. There are two partners, A and B. Okay, two partners were doing a partnership business for some times. Now they wanted to take a new partner called C. First of all, you should know what are the reasons of taking a new partner in the existing firm. A partnership firm can take a new partner in the firm because of several reasons. Like, see the first one, when more capital is needed. So with the passage of time, when a partnership firm expands its volume, automatically there will be more capital needed. As more capital is needed, so you may take a new partner, because when a new partner will come to the firm, that new partner will bring capital also. So automatically, with the admission of a new partner, generally the total capital of the firm increased. That is one reason. Okay. Second reason, experienced persons are needed. Sometimes the business work may become very complex, and for efficient management of the firm, some experienced persons are needed. So with this reason, as experienced persons are needed, so new partners can be taken in the firm. Third reason, to increase goodwill of the firm or the business. To increase the goodwill of the business. Partnership firm, like all other business, has its own goodwill. To increase the goodwill of the firm, a partnership firm may think to admit a renowned person who is maybe an industrialist who has a lot of goodwill. So once that person joins into the firm, automatically the total goodwill of the firm will also increase. Another reason, so the last one, to encourage a capable employee by taking him as a partner. So he was an employee. Employee means he is supposed to work for the business, and at the end of the month, he will get salaries. But to encourage the employees, a firm may have a separate plan. The plan is, if a person is capable to be the owner or a partner, so that employee can be given an option to become one of the partner. So these four are general reasons why a partnership firm take a partner in the firm. New partner. Why partnership firm take a new partner in the firm? Now come to another part. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Whenever a partner comes into the firm, automatically the profit sharing ratio of the existing partner gets changed. See one example I've given one example. See, there are two partners, okay. A and B. Let's take an example. The profit sharing ratio of A and B is 5:3. Okay, let's come to the question itself. Question number 1A. That is exercise 1A. From your book, you can see exercise 1A question. The question says there are two partners, A and B, and the profit sharing ratio of A and B is 5:3. So see the solution. Old share of A, okay, old share of A 5/8 and old share of B 3/8, because see the question is given in the book. The old profit sharing ratio of A and B both are old partners, their profit sharing ratio is 5:3. So A's share was 5/8 and B's share was 3/8. Then see the question says C is admitted to the partnership for 1/5 share of future profits. So new partner is coming C, and C is getting 1/4 share of profit. Now the question says calculate the new profit sharing ratio. New profit sharing ratio of whom? New proficient ratio of A, B and C, because earlier two partners were there, A and B. Now one more partner joined, that is C. So you have to find out the new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. See the solution. So old share of A 5 by 8 and old share of B 3 by 8. Let total profit be 1. Okay, let total profit be 1. As per the question, C is getting 1 by 4. So C gets 1 by 4. Total profit was 1. C gets 1 by 4. So remaining profit will be what? Remaining profit will be 1 minus 1 by 4. So remaining profit 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4. Okay, so C got, total profit was 1. C got 1 by 4. After profit given to C, the remaining profit is 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4. Now this 3 by 4 share of profit will be given to A and B. So it is also written, this 3 by 4 share of profit will be given to A and B in the ratio of 5 is to 3. What was the ratio of A and B? 5 is to 3. So this 3 by 4 share of profit will be given to A and B in the ratio of 5 is to 3. So A gets how much? 5 by 8 into 3 by 4. That is, if you multiply 15 by 32. Okay. Similarly, B gets 3 by 8 into 3 by 4. That is 9 by 32. So we got A share, B share and C share already given in the question 1 by 4. Therefore, new profit sharing ratio. So new profit sharing ratio of A, B and C. A share 15 by 32, B 9 by 32, C 1 by 4. LCM will be 32. If you do the LCM, then your ratio will be 15 is to 9 is to 8. So new profit sharing ratio among A, B and C will be 15 is to 9 is to 8. In this way, you can calculate new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. Thank you.